Hey guys, welcome back to another video in this series of Python for beginners. And as you can see on my screen today, we are going to talk about the operators. So there are many types of operator and let's discuss about that. Moving forward in the video, I would like to request, you know the drill, that if you have not subscribed my channel, kindly do so. So without further ado, let's dive right into the video. So the first operator that we know is arithmetic operator. We are going to discuss about that. After that, we are going to discuss about the comparison operators, then logical operators, then bitwise operators, then assignment operators, then identity operators, and then membership operators. After that, we are going to talk about the precedence. So we'll talk about how the precedence is taken when you declare two variables at the same time, or you give asterisk, you give slash, you give division, multiplication, how do they work. After that, we are going to talk about the associativity. Now, all these operators we are going to discuss with proper demo, and each and every demo will have proper code, and that code is already on my GitHub's account. You can clone that, or you can just copy paste, or you can write your own code. That would be very, very much recommended from my end. So let's dive right into the video. So first is arithmetic operators. You can see on my left it is written operator and the description and the syntax. So plus is the basic one, it adds two operand, minus subtracts two operand, asterisk is multiplication, two operands multiplication, then slash is division, float divides the first operand by the second, this is division, floor divides the first operand by the second. This is modulus, returns the remainder. If you want to store, you can just give an assignment operator which is equal to, which we will discuss further in this video, and then you can take the value. And double asterisk is the power, which means returns first raised to the power second. For example, if x is 2, y is 3, so 2 into 2 into 2, which is 3 times, means answer would be 8, and you can catch that value in any kind of variable. Let's move forward. Comparison operator. So basic ones, greater than, less than. So it compares whether it is true whether the left operand is greater than or right. You can see the syntax over here. Less than, x is less than y. It returns true after that. Equal to, it compares if the both operands are equal. So it compares both the operand. It is written like this. Not equal to, again, it tests both the operands are equal or not. If it's not, then it's true. Otherwise, it is false. You can see the syntax over here. And then greater than equal to. Greater than equal to means two conditions. First, it is greater, then it is equal to. So for example, x is 1 and y is 1. So x is 1, y is 1, which means it's not greater than 1, but it's equal to. So this would be true. So there are two conditions. Either it's greater, either it's equal. But in case, you can check over here, is less than equal to. Same thing, it's just either it's less or than equal to. So if x is 1, y is 1. So is 1 is less than 1? No, but that's one condition. What is the other condition? Equal to? Yes, it's equal to. So it will return true. Logical operator. So there are three types of logical operators over there. AND, OR, or NOT. AND has two conditions. True if the both operands are true. So if two conditions will meet, then it will come true. Otherwise, it will be false. And in OR, if there are two conditions, one of them has to be positive. So it means one of them has to be true, then it will work. NOT is like it just transforms one state to the other state. So true if the operand is false, false if the operand is true. So let's move forward. Bitwise operator. This is one of the most important topics, and there are interviews in which people write programs for this. They'll ask you to write a program on bitwise operator. You can explain. So if you're not able to understand it here, I'll give a demo on each and everything, and you can see that, and you can just copy that code from my GitHub repository. The code is updated over there. You can just check out from the description box link. Now let's move on the bitwise operators. This is ampersand, which is AND, bitwise AND, so X AND Y. This is OR, bitwise OR, X OR Y. Negation, or you can say bitwise NOT. If you have studied about digital electronics, then you must be aware about this. If you are just a student and have not gone through digital electronics, it's totally fine. You do not need any kind of prior knowledge over here. So this is bitwise XOR. It's a combination of two things, and then X XOR Y. It is right shift and left shift. So right shift and left shift is kind of important, and it is not happening on the numbers. It happens on the bits. Bits is something like when you have a number. Let's say you have 4, and then you try to make it on convert into bits. So you have to convert it to binary number, and then on that you have to operate bitwise right shift and left shift. So bit of a number in which you have to convert into a binary number. So that's how you understand it. It can look it's too much information. It might be like drinking from a fire hose right now, but it's fine. We'll go to the demo and we'll understand everything. Do not worry about that. Let's move forward. There are assignment operators. So assignment operators is the most like they are huge in number. So we have two screens dedicated for it. First is the basic one, which is equal to. So assign value of a right side of an expression to the left side. Basic. So if you do any kind of operation, it will assign over there. And then plus equal to. This is just fancy way of writing it. Plus equal to, minus equal to. It actually means a plus equal to b. It actually means a equal to a plus b. A equal to a minus b. A asterisk equal to b equal to a equal to a asterisk b. It's a short form of writing it. It just means the same thing. I prefer this one. This is some kind of confusing to me. So you can write either way. That's not an issue. Same modulus and. So what they are doing is they are using this basic operators, the arithmetic operators, and assigning with the assignment. You can see equal to is everywhere. So that is assignment operator working. And similar case in this divide floor and ceiling. So there is a concept of floor and ceiling. So for example, if there is a number 2.1, which is it's kind of floor, and if you are talking about ceiling, which is kind of 2.9. So that's the basic concept of floor and ceiling. We'll see more in the demo part. So assignment operator having everything with equal to, equal to, equal to, you can see over here. So in this one, you can write this way. This one you can write this way. This one you can write this way. This one you can write is just a way of writing. So their operation happening two times. First operation is this, second operation is this, and they have been writing in this way. So you can either use this. So let's move forward. The next is identity operator. So they are used to check if two values are located on the same part of memory. Why? Because two variables that are equal do not imply that they are identical. So you can use is and is not in your program, and is true to the operands are identical. If both the operands are identical, then it's true. Otherwise, it's false. And is not is true to the operands if they are not identical. So I hope this is clear to you. Let's move to the membership operator. So membership operators are used to test whether a value or variable is in a sequence or not. In true if value is found in the same sequence, not in true if the value is not found in the sequence. So that's how you understand membership operators. It's okay if it is too much information, too much theory right now. We'll move to the demo part and then understand each of them one by one what exactly is happening. So let's dive right into the video. Okay, so let's open our Visual Studio Code and then we'll dive into the demo part. So this is arithmetic. First of all, very basic example, x value is 19, y value is 4, and it'll add the value which is 23. This is minus 15. This is multiply, which is, I guess, 19, 4 is 13, 76. This little divide. Okay, let's understand this floor and ceiling concept over here. So let me just run this program first, 0, 1, hit enter. Now, 19 plus 4 is 23, 19 minus 4 is 15. You can see over here, 19 to 4 is 76. This one will give you the float value, which is the decimal value. So 19 divided by 4 is 4.75, and it has given the value. And in case of floor, so which I told you, right, if there is a value for if there is a value, then it will give 4 of 4.75. what is the ceiling value for this? The bigger value, which is 5. So that's how we design floor or ceiling. So had it been ceiling, then it would have been 5, but that's not how it works in Python 3. It works that way. So that's how it works. And modulo of both number, this is wrong. This should be have been B. I'll fix it and upload it on GitHub. Do not worry about that. And then over here, 19 modulo 4 is 19 divided by what we are doing is 19 divided by 4, which is 4 for the 16. The value is 3. So the answer is 3 over it. Perfect. And in this, the division, the main value, which is 4. Perfect. And then power. So 19 into 4 times. So 19 into 19 into 19 into 19. You can use a calculator and you'll see the value is perfectly all right. Okay, so this is how it works, and you can print the values. So this is very basic example. Let's move on to the second program, which in we have the comparison. So x equal to 133, y equal to 333. Okay, so is x greater than y? You ask yourself, pause this video right now, ask yourself this question. 133 is greater than 3, less than 3, equal to 3, does not equal to, greater than equal to, less than equal to. Answer yourself and then match. Do not read this green one, which is comment. And let us see how this works. 0 through, perfect. And then false, true, true. I hope you have done enough. Just put write everything into pen using pen or paper and then just match with this. If you have done that and if every answer is correct, you have perfectly understood the comparison, how it is done. Let's move to the logical part. Logical is basic thing. X is true, y is false. So x and y. So and has to have two condition as true. Only and only if two conditions are true, it will print true. Otherwise, it will print false, which is false. And then in or, either should be true. This is true, so this will print true. And not x will do the negation of, I mean, the reverse of it. So let me just run the 0, 3. And you can see false, true, and false. Perfect. Now we have the bitwise code. This is the one which I have kept for the last. We'll discuss at the end. Okay, let's move on to the assignment operator. So what is assignment operator? So a equal to 10, b equal to a. So what they are doing is giving variable a a value of 10 and then assigning the same value to b. So both of them are 10, 10. Okay. So if I print this, let me just clean this and 05 I have to run. Let me just clean this, 05 I'll run. Hit tab over here. And you can see when the value was assigned, it is 10. Now what they are doing is adding and assigning the value. They are adding by this, which is equal to this. So b equal to b plus a, which is 20. B equal to b minus a equal to 20 minus 10, which is 10 that has printed. And multiplication, same thing. B equal to b into 10, 10 into 10 is 100. So I hope this is clear as well. Let me close this as well. Okay, so this is done. Logical is done, I guess. Assignment is done. Let's move to the identity part. Now, what is happening in identity? A equal to 10, B equal to 20, and C equal to C. So, C equal to A. So, A, the value of A is going inside C. So, A is 10 right now, C is 10 right now, and B. So, A is not B. A is not B. So, 10 is not 20. True, it's not, right? Print A is C. A has value 10, C has value 10. So, both of them are same? Yes. So, both should have been true. So, let's run it and just justify the answer, and you can see the answer is true over here in both the cases. I hope this is convenient to you for you to understand. Let's go to the membership part. Now what we'll do is, list is another data structure that we have discussed that we will talk about this. For right now, you can just, it looks like an array. So it has a few values inside it, and then we are going to check whether A has a value 24, B has a value. It is a part of our list or not. So not in and in, we are going to test condition using if and else. We'll talk more about if and else in the future as well. So you can say A 24 is not a part of it. Okay. So what it will do, this will print this, and B in list, which is 20, is a part of this. Yes. So this will print. Yes. Present. Okay. So not in this. Let's run this and let's clear that out. See, A is not a part of given list. B is not a part of given list. Perfect. So this is how it's done. Let me close this and go to the precedence part. Okay, this is done. Yeah, precedence. Now what is happening in the precedence? So if you have plus and multiplication, how it will go? So there is a variable which is your expression exp, you can give any other name, 10 plus 200 into 300. How will it work? The multiplication will work first. Pay attention to these 3-4 programs: precedence, associativity, and this bitwise. Again, bring a paper, bring a pen, pause the video right now and just understand it, and after understanding only write your answer, and then you can check the answer of this question. Let me just clean this. Okay, so 200 into 300 is somewhere around, I guess, 60,000. Yeah, 60,000, and plus 100 will be 60,100. It will not happen like this way, 300 into 300, no, 9,000. No, that's not how it works. Let's just confirm this. So this is 08. Let me just tab, enter, and you can see this is 60,100. This will work like this, and then it will add the value. And if you talk about precedence of OR and always get the preference in case of OR. So let us prove this. Name equal to logic, age equal to 2. You can see in the same line we have used OR and. So these two conditions are for and these two conditions are for OR. So how it will work? It will go to the and first. So name equal to lab. So the name equal to lab. No, name is logic. So this one is false. Okay. Age is greater than equal to 4. No, false. So both of the conditions are false. So even if one condition is false, this whole will return as false. So now this is one condition and this has already given false. So in case of OR, name equal to logic. Yes, name is equal to logic. So this condition is true. And this whole condition is false, but OR needs only one condition, true. So yes, it will go inside, print hello, welcome. Perfect, and this is how it works. You can say hello, welcome. So I hope you have understood this. Now comes the best part, associativity. Left, right, associativity, and then right, left. Okay, so let's understand this first. So if you have given print 100 slash, which is division 10 asterisk, will this happen first or this happen first? This will happen first. So 10 will divide 100, which means the answer will be 10 and then multiply by 10, which is 100. So let us just confirm the 09, and you can see 100 is the answer. Pay attention, because in many interviews you have you get multiple choice question in which you have to write these kind of questions. This does not work in the board mass way. Do not be confused in that way. Now again, 5 minus 2 plus 3, left right associativity. So 5 minus 2 will happen first. So 5 minus 2 is 3, 3 plus 3 is equal to 6. This will happen. So the answer should be 6 and not like this. 2 plus 3, 5 minus 5 is 0. Now left right associativity only will work in the sense if there is a bracket, because bracket has the higher precedence. So this will take 2 plus 3 as the first thing, which is 5, and then 5 minus 5 is equal to 0, which is this. And then right left associativity come only at this cost of when you have raised to the power or you multiply it. So what will happen? This will happen only first. So 3 raised to the power 2. So 3 into 3, which is 9. Okay. And 2 raised to the power 9, which is 2 into 2 into 9 times, which is somewhere around 512. Okay. How do I remember it? Because 2 raised to the power 8 is 256. It's kind of imprinted. Okay. And that's how you get this answer. So I hope these things are clear to you. Okay. So what we'll do is we'll talk about the bitwise part now. And let's understand through this example, which I have shown. Okay, before moving that, let's not talk about these parts, because I'll show you an example. Let's talk about this part. Okay, print negation x, or bitwise not operation. So what will happen is everything that you happen in the bitwise happens on the bits, which is the binary values, not the numbers. So x equal to 7 we'll be using everywhere. So binary value of 7 is 011 and binary value of 4 is 0100. Okay, you can convert that. There are many converters online. Okay, now what will happen over here? Negation x will take each bit 0111 and then it will convert it into these values. So 0 negation is 1, negation of 1 is 0, 1 is 0, 1 is 0. So finally we have this value. If you convert this value into a number, this comes as 8, but there is a negation over here, which is it's a not over here, so that will come minus 8. So let us understand this. Let me clean this, and this is 04, hit tab, enter, and you can see that the answer is minus 8. We'll talk about 473 later. Minus 8. Okay, now let's move on to the print bitwise write. So what is happening? It is shifting to the right, as I showed that the value is 0111. Okay, it is shifting to the right. Now as soon as it shifts to the right, it loses one value, and then a zero is added to the left, and then again it loses one more value, which is one, and then this is the solution that is left. Now if you will convert this into a decimal system or a number, it will come as one. So the answer is one over here. Again, if you'll do bitwise left shift, left. So what you are doing is doing left shift. Okay. So 111 will shift one places to this, and a zero will be added at the end. So if you'll see, this is 1110. And then if you convert this into a decimal system, the value will come as 14. How do you do it? You have to multiply by the 2 and then you have to add the value. I'm not going to do it right now. You guys have to do it on your own. I hope you guys know binary system and the decimal system. If not, kindly go through other videos on the internet, or you can just Google. There are number of information available. So this answer is 14. When you shift double, so this is the one time shift, this is a double time shift. So two zeros are added, the value will become 28. Three times added, there are three zeros added over here, and triple one. Sorry, I just messed it up. Control Z. Okay. So the value will become 56, and then if you shift it six times, I've not written it, and you can pause the video over here, do your calculations and see if your answer comes as 448. So that's how you do it, guys. And yeah, on your right it loses the value, which is which you have seen over here, and on your left it does not lose the value. Make sure, okay, if this one goes, this will add more bits to it, like in terms of zero, it will not lose the value until unless there is some exception. Okay, so that's how it works. Now let's dive right into the bitwise AND, bitwise OR, and bitwise XOR. You know that it already has X as 0111 and Y already has 0100. And I'll give an example of this so that you guys can understand it.
So these three will be using in the bitwise. So this is bitwise AND operator, bitwise OR operator, bitwise OR operator. So concept explanation is something like this. If A has a value of 0 and B has a value of 0, then A and B, both the condition are fulfilled or not. So both the condition are not fulfilled. So it has to give 0. For OR, one condition has to fulfill. So no condition is getting fulfilled. So 0. And for XOR, it will give us 0 itself. So in AND, both the condition has to be fulfilled. In OR, one condition has to be fulfilled. So 0 is false, 1 is true. So when we say 0 here and 1 here, in AND, both the condition has to be fulfilled, but both are not fulfilled. What I mean by fulfilled is 0 is true. Sorry, 0 is false, 1 is true. So true and true has to be two conditions to be fulfilled. Then only it will get 1 over here. Okay. So 0 is there, 1 is there, one condition is false over here, then it should give us 0. And in OR, either condition should be fulfilled. So A is 0, but B is 1, and 1 is true. So this is fulfilled. So 1 over here. For XOR, we have 1 over here. So in this, either A or B has to, one of these values has to be 1, then it will be 1. Now, if A has 1 and B has 1, and which means both of them are true, so A and B will be true because both the condition are fulfilled. Now in A or B, it doesn't matter. It will be 1 because either A has to be 1 or B has to be 1. So it will give us 1. But in case of XOR, if both the conditions are fulfilled, it will give us 0 as it gave it in this 0 and 0. When A is 1, B is 0, A and B will give us 0. Why? Because one of these is false. As I told that 0, consider 0 as false. In A or B, it will give us 1 because one condition has to be fulfilled and one is already fulfilled. So 1 is true. Then in A, XOR, B, what it will do is it will give us 1 value. So that's what I told earlier, that either in XOR, either of A or B has to be 1. So that's how we explain bitwise operator. So the first one, bitwise operator takes the last two values of first and the other one and then calculate it. So in AND, both the condition has to be fulfilled. So 1 and 0 would be 0, 1 and 0 would be 0 again, 1 and 1 would be 1, and 0 would be 0. So what is this 011 in front of 7? This is a binary representation. So binary representation of 7 would be 0111, and for 4 it would be 0100. And after that, this bitwise, when it talks after the last two values, it will calculate on the basis of AND, and this is the truth table of AND gate. So now 1 or 0 would be 0, so this would be 0100, and this is a binary representation of digit 4, thus the answer is 4. Now let's move on to our fourth one, the OR one. The truth table of OR is that both of them has to be 1, then it will be 1, and then only it will be 0 when both of them are 0. So 1 and 0 would be 1, 1 and 0 would be 1, 1 and 1 would be 1 obviously, and 0 would be 0. So this is the representation in binary for number 7, and that's why the answer is 7. Let's move on to our XOR or XOR gate. This is the truth table. So when one of the values is 0, then the answer would be 1, like this and like this. Otherwise, it would be 0 if both the values are same. So in order to calculate that, we'll just convert this into binary. 0111, 4 would be 0100, and 3 is the answer, because 1 and 0 would be 1, which is taking a reference from here. 1 and 0 would be 1 again. 1 and 1 would be 0, and 0 and 0 would be 0. So 0011 is the binary representation of 3, and that's why the answer is 3.
So I hope everything is clear to you guys and you have understood everything over here, whatever we have discussed in terms of arithmetic, comparison, logical, bitwise, assignment, identity, membership, precedence, associativity, operators. This is not end of the road. You can write any number of programs. You can Google how many programs I can run on this. So start from today. Just open your Visual Studio Code, open your pen and paper and start writing programs, because that's how you get the that's how you get the grip over associativity and the precedence. Because even today I'm having around 9+ years of experience, and when I do coding part or scripting part, even I get confused, because whenever you are not in touch, you get confused a lot. So I hope my advice and this video is clear to you, and if there is anything that you need to understand, please feel free to comment below and we will address that issue. So thanks guys, and I'll see you in the next video.